Good morning, everyone. It's my honor to welcome you all in the second edition of Orange City Literature Fest, organized by SGR Knowledge Foundation. I, Apurva Ahuja, will be the anchor for this session, and the topic of this session is New Norms in Service, in conversation with Ravi Mishra. The guest for this session is Deepa Prasad. Dr. Deepa Prasad is a hotel management alumnus from IHMCT Mumbai. Her core expertise is in food and beverage services and management. She is a doctorate in management and her thesis was on wine consumption patterns. She has authored 4 books in the food and beverage services and international etiquette. She was invited as a speaker in Orange City Literature Fest 2019 for session on hospitality and etiquette. She has won awards for innovation in hospitality sector and honor for her contribution by Minister of Tourism, Government of India. Innovation and research is a domain area has led her to be invited and be part of international panel discussion in conference, as well as publish more than 30 research papers in UGS approved journals. Ravi Mishra will be the moderator for this session. Ravi Mishra, sir, has been awarded as Best Publication Professional by Management Guru Shiv Khera, Brand Ambassador for brands like Lotto Shoes and B&M Jeans, owner of famous brand INDINO Food Manufacturing Unit of Pasta and Noodles, current status Dean at G.H. Rai Sony School of Hospitality Management, member of Indian Federation of Culinary Association, Young Chef Association of India, and World Association of Chef Society. Selected in Team India to represent country for World Chef Congress 2020 to be held at St. Petersburg, Russia. Handing the session to you, Ravi, sir.
Thank you. A warm welcome to me and the speaker, Dr. Deepa Prasad. On behalf of Rising Group of Institutions, I welcome Dr. Deepa Prasad in the Orange City Literature Fest. We all heard very good, very warm introduction of our speaker. She is not a doctorate, also a beautiful lady, what we can see. So I welcome Dr. Deepa. And for the program. For the today's new normal in F&B service. Rather, new normal in service. So, before we start, I would like to start to the topics on the topic. Over to you, ma'am.
All right. I'm going to do a little bit of audio check because a little bit is getting cut for me when you're speaking. A very warm good afternoon to everybody at Nagpur International Literature Fest. Namaskar. And to everyone around the world who's going to watch today. Muskan has lit us with her smile. A lovely introduction. Of course, Mr. Ravi Shankar Mishra is always a pleasure to interact with him. Such a dynamic personality. And I would really like to thank the Rai Sony Group because they've kept the tradition on of the Orange City Literature Fest after a very successful launch last year. It was absolutely electric, the atmosphere being in Nagpur. With today's time, it's virtual, and I am absolutely confident that next year again, we will be transcending in Nagpur. My core expertise, as introduced, has always been in food and beverage service, I have worked extensively with organizations such as Taj, and have been in teaching for now more than a decade, as well as continuous interaction with other industry, whether it's hospitality, hotels, the wine, and other associations. So when we discussed what should we talk about in service between me and Mr. Mishra, we thought for our students, for people looking at us, Literature Fest should talk about what's happening now, correlate with past, correlate with future. And therefore, our discussion for today is new normal in service. Khana aur peena, luckily, is a more than a physiological need, not just for Indians, but for everybody. So whether it is COVID, non-COVID, wo to chalta hi rehta hai. Now the question is, how do we get the customers back to the hotels? How do we get them back to the restaurants? How do we get them back to QSR? And we're talking about every food, from street food to food which is served in a star category hotel. So should we just have a Q&A, or how do you do it, Mr. Ravi? I'll just brief a little bit, and then
what we'll do, we'll focus on few questionnaires. What I have gone through, what we have discussed rather before this session. And these questions are not right. Made by you. It's a little bit of R&D has been done to find out this question. So this is just a very normal, being a customer, a very frequent customer for I am a foodie, rather I'll say. So how would you define new normal in sector, ma'am?
Right. So that's what this is, I've been an ongoing discussion last few months, because we were in hibernation for 2-3 months. We are out of it now. The great news is, I think we're almost on our feet. Every type of food outlet has opened up in almost across states in India. So I'm just going to give certain things which I was talking to chefs from Conrad Bangalore to Bombay to Pune to Delhi, and what they are doing, and what are the new normals, not only in hotel, but also standalone restaurants and QSRs. I think in service today, for a customer as well as for people serving, the buzzword is collective responsibility. Jab bhi hum ghar se bahar nikalte hain khane ke liye bhi, we are as responsible, and responsibility does not just lie at the place we are going to eat. So this collective responsibility is a big term which all of them are promoting, because yes, we all wear our mask, we wear our shields, we are careful as customers, and we should not step out if we know that we are unwell to begin with as customers. In hotels per se, they're welcoming guests with their arm open. Hotels, I think, have become, I'm talking about star category hotels, have become an absolute bubble of safe environment for service. They follow social distancing norms, where even seating of a customer or is about at least a 6 feet distance between two customers, a table minimum, or 2 meters for each of them. Digitalization of technology is taken over in a big way, even to a medium-sized restaurant, a standalone restaurant, and even takeaways. As we all know, most of us use apps for takeaways. It could be an Bonvoy app of Marriott's, or Hilton has started their own apps. And these are two big chains which almost rule all the hotels in Pune. They have made it totally, absolutely no touch zone, where you could just come to the hotel, check-in is done without going to a check-in counter. You don't have to use an elevator. You put an app and it takes you to the floor where your restaurant is. You go to a table on the table. Again, it is cashless because you have a QR code on the table. Use the app and you get the menu down and you order food. And of course, again, payment is done from the app. So if somebody really wants no touch scenario, they could go ahead with that. But then there's also a second school of thought. This is minimalistic service. But for us, hospitality profession, not just because we are traditional or from the a little bit, not the millennial generation, there is some amount of, why do we go out? We need some amount of personalization. We need that smile. We need that muskan when we go to any outlet also. And we need to be felt that there is an ambience. So even hotels like Ritz-Carlton, etc., they do keep standard menu cards because we like the feel of going through it. So they cater to both type of customers. There are customers, millennials, who don't want any touch at all. And there are some traditional people who still want the menu cards. But what do they do? They sanitize it in front of you and give the card to you. And of course, it is told again, they sanitize after the card is given back to it. I can go on. Is there something you... now, coming back to putting in question in service, when I said collective responsibility today, staff is very important. Even at home, a person who cooks the food, we need to have that kind of reliability that I'm going to this person and he's going to serve me food which is not contaminated from the source, from the raw material to the cooked product, you know. So again, Conrad has come out with this concept of pan to plate and using indigenous food material. Why am I naming Conrad? Because just a few weeks back, they were in the star category hotel. They were named the best, safest, hygienic condition star category hotel. And they are running full this week. So when they're running full, that means they've done it. The customers are absolutely rely on what they do. So what they have done is they have this concept of, they have two apps again. One is an app for check-in. Another app is for event management app. They cook all food on live counters, but stations have glass, shields in front of it. They've started this very unique concept called as, this is started by, I have to name him because Chef Praveen, very proud. So he started this unique concept of having a culinary studio concept. So a culinary studio is where they give you a various choice of various courses on live counter in a buffet or on a menu card, something like a set menu card. In F&B people, we call it table d'hote menu. Mm-hmm. It's again become popular. So look at the change from buffets. We are coming back to serving on the table, you know. So serving on the table becomes personalized. But at the same time, how do we get less contact? So he's made this culinary studio. I could just order one course or I could order limitless and then accordingly I'll pay. And all this is done live in live counters, but we don't go to the counter. They make it and from pan to the plate is a concept. So they're working on 2-3 things, serving fresh food, serving indigenous food. The menu is limited, but it's absolutely made in front of you and served directly to you without anyone in between. So I think that's wonderful. I think the same concept to a street wala, because wo kya karta hai, wo aapke saamne hi banata hai actually. So, you know, whether it's a bhel or whether it is a vada pav or whether it is a dabeli, it's pan, it's you know, he's done the same. So I think they have realized also, because this is something, a little bit of research I had done, whether it's Delhi or whether it's Pune, a lot of them know that they want to get back on the street. This pandemic has made everybody scared. It's from a very a common man to a lower class to an upper class. Everybody is scared because life is important for everyone. And so is food. Food is a common binder. You know, it cuts across social standing, if I can say that. So many of them in the same concept have not only used gloves, make fresh food. They just make it 1 hour before. Because there is some amount of check from the government also. And they themselves, I've seen them being very diligent about wearing masks, asking their customers not to come close by if they're not wearing masks. And packaging, food packaging is a big, big, big thing now. So again, coming back to conferences, because this is where the money is in a bada sa party, whether it's outdoor, whether it's a small catering wala, whether it's a big banquet event management in a hotel. How do they work? What do they do? Of course, hotels have a very strict policy nowadays. They have limited the number of guests in the banquet hall. So it's really 1/4 to before. But they have very, very interestingly, when I went for one function, so now being invited is big because 50 guests may say, You have to be part of the list, so you know. So once you go there, the hotel, first thing in Marriott, they do that. Some hotels do that. They ask if you have this Arogya Setu app on your mobile, because that is one way of saying collective responsibility. Are you safe? You're, you know, they are telling you. Mask, temperature, oximeter have become common. I think even small organizations, societies do that now. They ask you again, because when you go inside a hall, you have a thing of, you know, you believe that other people will also be as safe as you. And if you're eating food, you obviously have to remove your mask. So there is going to be some amount of interaction inside a banquet hall. But in banquet hall, they've stopped serving food around like we do for cocktails. You know, go around, serve food on trays to customers. Instead of that, they made stations where they've done toothpicks, finger bite thing, where you could just pick up and again keep space between onto it. Again, a very interesting concept is something like Liquid Chef. So what's a Liquid Chef? It's a bar. But again, a bar is a place where people, you know, typically it was a place where everybody converges, talks, hangs around, and people, you don't want them to hang around. So they've got the Liquid Chef concept where a lot of pre-mixed cocktails are done and put in certain places. So, you know, if I know that there's a particular crowd where mojito will be popular, or you know, a margarita, depending on the weather condition, because these are popular drinks, which Cuba Libre, which goes well with season, then certain pre-mixed drinks are tagged, put over there, just as we used to circulate soft drinks around. Similar with wine and glasses. So customers could just go and help themselves to the particular drink and the finger bites. So less number of people. Into it, of course, some hotels have increased the cost of their menu cards. Some hotels, depending on the cities, have not. They are bearing the cost because they want the customers to come back to that particular restaurant or to a particular hotel. Restaurants are doing the same. Some restaurants, because how much can you invest? And then there's also a policy of zero tolerance in a five-star or seven-star. I would not expect that maybe in a regular, very normal outlet. Where they have, it's a stark table. You know, we are so used to going to a hotel where the table is set, cutlery is there, plate is there, we just come and sit down. So they have a stark table, nothing on the table. You come and then they wipe the table down in front of you. Linen is passé. Nowadays, very few places they put linen. It's just a stark, they wipe it in front of you. And then they get a cutlery trolley, which has ultraviolet rays in it. And just like how you go to a dentist and he removes all the equipment right in front of you, because that creates that, creates the goodwill which you require with a customer. Then they lay the cover right in front of you. And of course, it's without saying, wearing gloves, wearing a protective mask and the shield for service faculty. This is both, I would say, for the person serving as well as for the customers, important. And after every customer must go, they change their gloves and they strip down the table again and clean it again. These are some certain things which have taken up. So hotels are doing good business now, you know, and I think with changing times, there is always new innovation. Takeaway is huge. Takeaway was a concept which we thought was a regular restaurant or a place which does not have space, but they market it and they sell it. And then I'll use apps like Swiggy, etc. I have takeaways. But I think that's a big lesson for standalone restaurants as well as hotel restaurants. They've realized there's a huge market for takeaway. As long as you give quality food, you give food which remains good in the takeaway boxes. Just because I'm talking about takeaway, so I asked another person, what do you do? Because hotels, typically events, a lot of them are corporate lunches, corporate meetings, board meetings. So one more, and just as we had after 26/11, where people were okay, because after the attack for security check, today customers are also okay as long as they know they're safe. So hotels are investing on lovely packaging. They're called bento boxes, a tad expensive, but they keep the food in a in a good condition. It also ensures there's contactless to the food till it comes from the chef to the customer. So corporate people are given these bento boxes. So they open it up and they eat it while, you know, the lunch break or is there. And again, these boxes are disposed of. So, you know, in this way, the cost is not given to the customer, but in the new normal, two things the customer is looking. Obviously, when we eat food, our basic concept does not change. We want food in the right temperature, the right taste, the right ambience. That's why we go out. Otherwise, why should I go out, you know, to eat? But at the same time, with the safety concern being paramount and the quality of food also, whether it's street food, etc., the sourcing of the food has become important. And takeaways really are working on packaging and ensuring food remains in danger, you know, not come into the danger zone till you eat. Well, that was a very short thing of the new normal. There are many more, but I'll hand it over to Mr. Mishra to carry on. I'll speak about certain more concepts which are there.
Yes, ma'am. You said zero tolerance in the new service. So what I have seen, what people are observing, not only for the five-star hotels, what we are witnessing, the local street people, which caters a very huge platter of the common people, they are also following all these. And you will witness they are wearing the gloves. They have their own sanitizer. So small things they are taking care of. So if we talk, it's where everybody is now very conscious about this, and they are giving the focus on this pandemic. So again, I think it's win-win if it is open and people follows and people. Again, what to say? अगर people contribute करते हैं और support करते हैं तो will win the pandemic.
Yeah. I agree with you. Go on, sir.
Yeah. So how organization coping internal and external guests according to the situation, madam? Can you please focus on this?
Yeah, sure. Very well said, Mr. Mishra. Because to be honest, I love this word collective responsibility, because we should not say that, but we always have to think of blaming the other party or expecting the restaurant or the service provider to do, the government to do. So I think we have to realize, what are we doing? What are we contributing? You know, when I step out from my house, and if I have some expectation, then collective responsibility will be there. If people who are from the unorganized sector and uneducated sector may not be totally uneducated, like even a pani puri wala aajkal, I've seen him talking about how they use mineral water in the pani. Gone are the days where nail ke saath gol guppe ko, you know, make a hole in it. So they wear gloves to it. They talk about the quality of the water which is there. I saw him keeping a sanitizer. I also saw that he just ensured three people are there, 1, 2, and 3, so that he could give, not that 8, 10 of us putting a hand out for that pani puri, you know. So he kept that social distancing while serving. Fantastic, you know, because, yes, sir.
Yeah, they have,
yes, Mr. Mishra.
They have made a small presentation on the screen in the pani puri thela. And they are showing the process, how they are making, how they are doing their biza plava. They are showing the life to the audience that what are the precaution we are taking. So it's up to us ki how we are taking it. So it is
right
from the small people rather than a big brands.
You know, so rightly said, because a bigger organization or medium-sized organization have training teams, they educate us. And here are people, they are educating us because they realize their livelihood is based on this. So their livelihood is based on the fact that they are safe and they keep the customer safe. If they don't, then it's not viable. That's the same thing. Our industry, when we talk about hospitality and the food industry, it's been a tough time. But as I said, we are absolutely coming to the dawn again. And this New Year's, I'm sure we're going to ring in with all cheer, which is a typical trademark of any service industry. The reason, again, is because we have adapted. You know, there's acceptance first from the street vendor to the top person. This is a new norm, right? And once you accept it, then you adapt. Once you adapt, you have to ensure that you're consistent in what you're doing. So internal customers means staff. If hotels, we've heard about many hotels have either decreased the pay of their staff, or some of them have told them to stay back at home till the service improves or business works. So when they go back, they realize that they need to be healthy for their family as well as for this particular restaurant to work. Because the moment there are 2-3 cases, again, the restaurant or the outlet or the pani puri wala ka hath gadi will shut. So they are taking precautions, which we normally take. If they are unwell, I think you have to say, I'm unwell. That's it. I can't afford to come and engage with the customer. Hotels nowadays, I know from 3-star to 5-star, have a hygiene manager in their premises. Why only hotels? Even corporate sector, which has industrial canteen. Today, I'm working in a college. We have institutional catering. And we also have hygiene managers who does audit without letting you know. So he will just take one staff out and ensure that, take out his gloves and check if it's for contamination. Because in a hotel, every 4 hours, they have to change their gloves and their mask. Every 4 hours. But that only a big hotel can afford. A smaller place will have to find out another way of doing it. And they check their temperature and they check the other parameters. And this is zero tolerance to internal customers. Now, they are taking care of their own staff for two reasons. They don't want staff to contaminate each other and also the guest. And they want them to be healthy because only then look at it in a bigger way. If we do business, there is more business. If we don't do business, then we're going to all sit at home. So I think that is something which has come. Then the next part is for staff and staff room, our own eating, how many people to come into a locker room to change, how many people to go into a canteen to eat, how much can you do? So they're restricted again, locker rooms only X amount. Of course, most places they're using alternate day staff, or they've downsized till the business really comes in full strength put together. But they don't allow more than X amount of thing in their locker room. They also ensure that if they go to a canteen to eat, there are gone are the days ki hum sab milke khayenge, gappa shappa karenge during our break. They have shields over there again. And I think we have realized. I mean, even today when I have my lunch or something, I maintain the distance with another person. Nothing, because here zero tolerance means just because you look healthy, you look good, or you look fine, doesn't mean you cannot be a carrier. Anybody could be a carrier. So that realization has come to a street person. It should come to a bigger organization.
Correct. Technical team, just see, speakers, video has been paused. Can you please reconnect speaker? Host. Okay. So if you can connect her, because she will be launching a book. She will be revealing a book for the F&B service. So it has to be connected. Inko thoda connect kariye jaldi se. You can call her, Radha. If she can join through voice also, it's fine. Okay. Okay, fine. So, Apurva, is there any questionnaire from viewers? Just see the chat box.
Yes, sir. So, give me one sec.
Yeah. I think she has lost her connectivity. No problem. No problem. So I would like to thank our speaker, Dr. Deepa Prasad. She has given a quite good or informative information for a new normal in service industries. Though maximum people are aware what is the new scenario, new normal, in our daily curriculum. Apart from that, she has focused in a lot many new things which we were not aware, rather. So it was pleasure hearing her, and thanks to her for her valuable time sharing with us. And again, from behalf of Orange City Literature Fest, I would like to thanks our speaker, Dr. Deepa Prasad. I would like to thanks the organizer and the Please, ma'am. We were waiting for you since.
Yeah. I didn't realize it got connected. I thought I was still connected to it.
अरे आप कहाँ चले गए थे? आपका book का reveal होना है. मैं तो sum up कर रहा था.
अच्छा, am I audible now?
Oh yes.
Alright. I think So this is with virtual. We have to take into consideration a bit of it. I think I spoke more. Most of it. The way forward, Mr. Mishra, is that we are all waiting to celebrate our New Year's, Christmas. Last week, I was invited for. So last week, I was invited for this typical dry fruit mixing for the plum cake for Christmas. The only difference was they didn't allow us to do the mixing. They had put us in cubicles where we could see the chefs all got together and did it. You know, I mean, it just gets the spirit of, you just feel that everything is normal again. And it gets that Christmas spirit together. So the same thing they're doing. Hotels are putting up Christmas trees, inviting guests in a different time of the day to come and put up the, you know, the typical regular guests to put up the decoration, etc. And a very unique concept, I think even small resorts are putting it now, is that, and to bigger hotels, is they are telling you all to come for New Year's Eve, but they are telling you to use, it's a package, room plus the New Year Eve night, even if you are a local person. So they can decrease the number, you stay in the room because you go through all the checks and then you go down for a New Year celebration. I feel good celebrating with someone else because all the checks have been done. But then we go in. Obviously, numbers will be much smaller. So I think in the new normal, everybody's coped. And I think we should cope. We should go on because takeaways have become huge. We are eating healthier. We are the service provider providing healthier food in a cleaner way. So look at the positive. Iske wajah se abhi cleanliness, hygiene, sabki ekdam badh gayi hai upar, both of the customer as well as of the service provider. And we've gone indigenous. And we have gone back in some bulk, we have gone to personalization, but contactless, less amount of contact in personalization of what the customer wants. So I think it's fantastic. Service still goes on. Yes, sir.
So nice to hear that.
So, to serve it love.
So we'll go for the book launching formality, madam. Before that, would love to hear you the highlight of the book, and lot of viewers also wants to hear the highlight. Just focus a little bit of the highlight of the book, ma'am.
Thank. First thing again, I like to thank the Rysoni Group. I think they've been very lucky for me. They've managed to motivate me to come out with some books, because there was years. These are decades of notes of information you collect, and then you realize at one point you want to put it in black and white so that you can give it to your readers. In my case, a lot of my students, which are there, both past, present, and future. As well as a lot of my industry professionals who have absolutely always helped me to be in touch with what's happening. So the first book which I would like to launch, I think because of the bitter in age, it's called Food and Beverage Service, Practicals and Technique. It's co-authored with Professor Ullas Chaudhary. I wanted him to join today. It would be nice. What we came out with is we came out with 50 SOPs which are standard service norm, whether it is a very small restaurant or a QSR to a very fancy restaurant in a hotel. 50 things you need to do. A person has to know. So that it starts with a basic laying of a table to service of water, to finally operating a restaurant, how to open a new restaurant, to how to do duty rota, etc. And for each of them, we've kept a practical worksheet or a card. So that we've made SOPs very simple to the point. And the worksheets are your own input. Other hospitality professionals will implement it in their particular way, which they want for their particular student. So this is a book, and I would really recommend it's worth every pie for any professional, because it's something for a student of any hospitality courses, whether it's in Rysoni Group or elsewhere. This book is from first year to third year, whatever practical is there in your syllabus. We've done enough R&D of IHM syllabus, our syllabus, syllabus of other university, UGC syllabus. All practicals from first year to final year are mentioned out here. So this is our first book. It's our small way to give it. And if you're opening an outlet or a restaurant and you want to not invest on a trainer from outside, buy this book, and I think you can take your own staff training. The second book which is there is what is my been my lifelong passion. I would like to dedicate this book to my two professors of Institute of Hotel Management, Dadar Catering. If I can get a picture of this later, it will mean a lot to me. One is Mr. Gomes, who taught us service and ignited the passion of wines. Day for yesterday, we heard a very sad news. Chef Coelho, who taught us food production, huge mentor to everyone. Anyone who meets him, he becomes a mentor. His contribution to not only production, but to elevate the level of teaching for students is unparalleled. I'd like to dedicate both the books to them because they inspire us what people should be, people with soul in what you teach. And so is food. Food is always with soul, and so is beverages. This book on beverages service is a book. I got my first read done by, I hope it's okay, Avinash Deshmukh is general manager in ITC, my classmate and colleague, an F&B professional for years. And I said, is it okay or not? And he said, Deepa, this is so to the pinpoint that, you don't have to Google, you don't have to surf. It's got everything from spirits to fermented beverages, and of course on wines of various country, traditional, new world country, with brand names, service, what should be the service standards and the glassware, everything. So this is beverage service, and that's why we called it beverage. And somewhere beverage makes a core part of revenue earning, but it's not elevated. Therefore we call it art of service, because it's something beautiful to serve. It should not just be a glass which is given to a customer. So it's an art of service which makes it different. All service people who have worked in hotel and spent hours doing it know what I'm talking about. So this is our second book on beverage service, dedicated to Mr. Gomes as well as Chef Vernon Coelho. Thank you, both of y'all. for getting me to where I am today.
Can we hear aloud for Dr. Deepa and team publishers?
Thank you so much. I'll tell Ulas also. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. Always.
So from this, as our time also permits that we should stop. So I would hand over this session to Muskan. So behalf of Rayasani Group, I would thank Dr. Prasad, Orange City, and you, Muskan.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, ma'am. On behalf of Orange City Literature Fest, we sincerely express our gratitude towards your acceptance for this session and knowledge shared with us. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Twenty years of existence. Two universities, 23 educational institutes, offering 137 courses. Rayasani Group of Institution Beyond.